Hey everyone, just a quick word before we get started on this beer review. If you're interested in purchasing any of these beers that you see on my channel, stick around to the end of the video and I will tell you where you can purchase them at online. Now, isn't that lovely? Have beer shipped right to your home and don't have to go anywhere. All right, enjoy the video. Cheers to that. Welcome, my friends. Here we are once again to sample some more great tasting international craft beer with Dr. Dave. Fantastic, baby. Now, for our sampling pleasures and tasting delights today, we have one from Lindeman's Brouwerij. I think that's how you pronounce it, Brouwerij. Yeah, this is from Vlezenbeek, Belgium. I believe I pronounced that correctly. Vlezenbeek. And this is the Framboise Raspberry Lambic Beer. Now, this is for lightweights, my friends, because it only checks in at 2.5% alcohol by volume. It's a very small bottle, too, 250 milliliters, which is a shade less than 8.5 ounces. Oh, yeah. This is a very good beer for men or women who are out on possibly a first date or any date, for that matter, and they don't want to get too tipsy. No, you're not going to get too tipsy on this beer. I don't know what's under the foil here. It's a plain. No, it's not a plain Jane. Ah, good thing that I opened that nicely. It's got the Lindeman stamp on there, so we'll peel that off later. I won't keep you waiting. I haven't had this for a long time, but it's a very good beverage indeed. Now, I happen to have the gold-rimmed glassware. The footed glassware, oh, lovely baby. Got to have proper glassware. This pours out like a rosé red wine. Look at it. Isn't it beautiful? Look at the head on that. It's very well carbonated. Now, there's a lot of adjuncts in here, so some people will say, hey, it's not really a beer. I can smell the raspberries right from here. I don't need to get it up to my nose. I got them right here. That's how strong this is. Oh, that's just wonderful. Look at that liquid loveliness. Let's put it over here away from that bright light. Oh, my gosh. When it gets over here, it's a beautiful ruby color. Oh, yeah, because there's not much light over on this side. Oh, man, is that nice or what? Cheers. That is refreshing. Now, when people think of raspberries, they think of tartness. These are very sweet raspberries, because there's some sweetener added in here. I don't know what it is, natural sweetener. So it's not tart at all to me. Now, some people might drink this and say, what the hell is he talking about? This is tart. I don't like it. It's sweet. Trust me, it's sweet. I'm telling you, this is a good beverage to have when you're on a date and you just want to drink something other than a Coke or a Pepsi or a root beer, whatever turns you on. You know what I mean? Yeah, when you're in a very high class establishment, very upper crust, if you will. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about, baby. You don't want to sit there and drink some soda. No, you want to have yourself one of these. Very good. And most establishments that I've been in serve the beverage in this glassware. Now, a lot of times you're not going to see that gold rim up there. It's just a plain glass. But, you know, some of your upscale, if you will, your upscale bars will have this. And they'll also charge you about $10 for this small bottle. Yeah, baby. I'm going to sit here, relax, and enjoy this liquid loveliness. If you've never had anything from Lindeman's, you should try. They have this one, the strawberry. They have this is the raspberry. They have a strawberry. They have a Concord grape. They have peach, which is called Pesh. And there's something else. They have five that I recall. Yeah, they're all very good, though. And they're not going to get you tipsy. 2.5%. You'd have to drink quite a few of these to get a buzz, I tell you that.
All right, my friends, that's it for now. Cheers.
Okay, everyone. As promised, Dr. Dave's going to tell you where he buys his beers and where you can buy them also. First on the list is rivalrybrews.com. Now, don't worry, I'm going to put the links in the description box for you. Rivalry Brews is a relatively new mail order place. It's based right here in Ohio in Medina, and they are fantastic. I tell you what, when they first started, I got free shipping on all the beers. Now, I think they charged me $2. $2 for 12 beers, that's fantastic. Now, as far as I know, they ship to the lower 48, but you might want to check the website on that. I can't be 100% sure. But the shipping is fast. The turnaround is fast. And if anything's wrong, they will fix it right away. I only had one issue with them, and they refunded half my purchase order, which I thought was more than fair. More than fair. So anyway, by the way, disclaimer, I don't get any money on any of this. I'm not affiliated with any of these beer companies. They don't know I'm doing this. I'm just telling you where to buy the beer. Now, one day I may be affiliated, and if I am at that point, I'll certainly let you know. So Rivalry Brews, located right here in Ohio, they specialize in Ohio beers. Beers from Pennsylvania and Indiana. So if you want some good Ohio craft beer, that's a good place to start. The second one on my list, oh, I love this place. It's called Halftime Beer. Halftime Beer has two locations in New York State, Poughkeepsie, and I believe it's pronounced Mamaroneck. Mamaroneck. Yeah, don't quote me on that pronunciation. I tried my best. Yeah, anyway. They have more beer online than you could possibly look at in a day. I'm telling you, they have beer everywhere on that website. And all you have to do is go on there, make your selection, and have it shipped. Now, they do have gift boxes, which come with a really nice cooler. Yeah, and you can't beat it. It's $5 shipping on those special orders. Now, on the other beers, the shipping can get a little bit pricey, but I've never had an order for more than $20 shipping, which I think is really good for 12 bottles of beer. Now, if you get cans, it's less cost because it weighs less. And that's what costs the money is the weight and the size of the box. So, yeah, check them out. Now, I belong to two of their what's known as Beer of the Month Club. I'm in their German Beer of the Month Club, so I get 12 bottles from six different breweries, two of each, once a month, and there's a lot of beers in there that I've never heard of from Germany. I thought I had them all, not even close. And then I have the Around the World Beer Club, which is exactly what it sounds like. It's beers from all over the world. So far, I only got one beer that I didn't really like. You know, it happens. It happens. And, you know, you take your chances on that. But I got some beer from South Korea, of all places, South Korea. I thought it was really, really good. Now, last on the list, but not least, and I didn't put these in any particular order, it's the Best Damn Beer Shop. Now, they're out of San Diego. And they have a killer selection, I'm telling you. Matter of fact, talking about all this beer, I'm going to have one here. That's just a regular run-of-the-mill Pilsner, German style, but it hits the spot on a day like this. Anyway, Best Damn Beer Shop. Woo! Now, their shipping, they require you to choose in lots of six. So you can get 6, 12, 18, 24 is the maximum. And their shipping is reasonable, considering I'm on the East Coast and they're on the West Coast. Yeah, the shipping is generally about $19 for a 12-bottle selection, which I don't think is a lot. $19? No, I don't think that's a lot. Now, the more beer you buy, the less money it's going to cost. That's just a fact of economics. So if you want to buy six beers, it's going to cost more to ship it than the 12. Hey, I don't make the rules, man. Just buy more beer. You save more money on shipping. What can I tell you? Yeah, but they're a great place, and so all three of those places, Rivalry Brews for Ohio beers, and then you have the Halftime Beverage, which is in New York. They have a selection on everything, and same thing with Best Damn Beer Shop. Now, if you want some West Coast beers that you can't find in your town, that's the place to buy them at. Last but not least, people always ask me, what is that on your beer glass? Well, I bought it at Amazon.com. It's called a vacuum vin. Vacuum vin. And if I'm not mistaken, it's from Sweden, if I'm not mistaken. And the inside of it is lined with special material. So what you do is you put this in the freezer, you let it sit overnight, and then you put your beverage in here, and it will maintain that beverage at around 38 degrees, which is really cold for a beer, but I like my pilsners cold. Now, if you already have a beer that warmed up, put it in here and it'll bring it to the proper temperature, no doubt. And I said last, but I was mistaken. This is the last thing I want to talk about. Dr. Dave's beer glasses. Now, I did sell these a number of years ago when I had my other beer channel. And this is a new design, though. This is a different design. Now, I could sell these if there's enough interest in them, but I have to order them. About 144 at a time. So I don't want to order them unless there's some real interest in them. Now, it's difficult to see on here, but it says Dr. Dave's cheap ass beer reviews. Yeah, it's not really going to come out that well there on the camera, but I would sell these at cost. Now, I'm not trying to make any money on them. I think it cost me $14.98 to have those made. So I would sell them at the same price. Now, I don't know if the price could have gone up because I did buy those a few years back. So, but I would sell them at cost if anybody's interested. But like I said, I don't get any money off these links. There's no affiliate links here. I'm not making any money. I just wanted to let everybody know where I buy my beer so you could buy it too. Oh, and you know, I almost forgot the Amazing Clubs Beer of the Month Club. Amazing Clubs. I'll put all the links in the description box. Knock yourself out. Hey, thanks for watching, okay? And Dr. Dave says, cheers to that.